Yeah, it's 8:42 at warm on a 1.3 from Greece, Athena. When did you graduate, Kevin Green?
Way back in 2002.
2002.
Oh, way my back. Gosh.
And you were on the TV show, the Greece TV show. And
yeah. Greece, you're the one that I wanted right? to do the Find the Danny and Sandy on Broadway and all that stuff.
That was kind of cool. How was that awesome. As an experience? It had to be an
You know, it's life-changing. It's one of those things where the rush of being like, okay, I'm about to perform live in front of like mm-hmm. 8 million people.
8 million people.
It's kind of crazy.
But, I mean, what's the biggest crowd you've been in front of?
I mean... Crowd.
Well, I mean, that you've done your show.
3,000 people, I think.
Seriously?
Performed. Yeah,
wow.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
That was up. I did a gig in Canada, and there was 3,000 people.
Wow. So then, when you go to do this, you know there's 8 million people watching.
Absolutely.
So.
Yeah.
But it did lead to so many different things, even though you didn't get that part. You got
actually, they did Phantom of the Opera week on that show, and actually ended up booking my first Broadway show from that.
Wow.
So there was A Tale of Two Cities, which is kind of like a big, you know, legit kind of old school musical, and they saw me sing Phantom, and come on in.
So what other things have you done on Broadway?
Well, just that. I did Mamma Mia out in Las Vegas.
Okay.
Done some
sounds like fun.
Yeah, that was a riot out there. That was a riot. I did some off-Broadway stuff, some more TV stuff. I did a Gossip Girl
I saw that in your bio.
Yeah.
Was that in L.A.?
No, that was here. They actually filmed it in New York.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so there's a lot of TV and film, actually, in New York City. It's kind of coming there because Bloomberg did a tax thing to get more folks there. Yeah,
I know. It's so hard to tell these days which shows are actually there and which shows are not because a lot of them are, you know, based there but not really shot there. But they do such a good job of doing it. And then you can't even tell. I mean, when they shoot the exteriors, you think, okay, it could be real, could be fake.
Absolutely.
But looking good. No, that's kind of nice. So you're based then basically in New York. You're not going
to... I'm based in New York. I think there might be an L.A. move for me in the next year or two.
You want to do TV? You want to do movies?
You know, I just want to be creative. Mm-hmm. 9 to 5 is like not my thing. Yeah. I just can't do it. I'm not hardwired
for
that.
We're all the same way.
Yeah. So it's just keeping it fresh. You know, I think of it like diversifying my acting portfolio, or whatever it is. Mm-hmm. The more things you can do in different ways, be it acting, directing, whatever. Like, you know, it's more stuff. So.
You said you had a touring thing too. You're doing?
Yeah, I perform with this group. This is actually my side job. Since I have to like wait tables when I'm between gigs. I do this thing. It's called Bel Note Solutions, and what it is, they do like a Frankie Valli show, a Beach Boys show, and like a Broadway show.
Oh,
and we'll go to like different corporate events. They'll hire us out. I'll like fly to Cleveland for a night, do a gig, then fly back.
Oh, how cool is that?
Yeah, and it gets really tough when sometimes cruise ships hire you out for guest performance slots. So sometimes I'm forced to go to like Bora Bora for 5 days.
And
it's tough. It's hard work.
You need a roadie.
Yeah. So
we're speaking with Kevin Green. Now you're in a play that's in Rochester here tomorrow with the Empire State Lyric Theater. Tell us a little bit about this thing.
Yeah, this is it's a children's show called Custard, the Cowardly Dragon. It's I'm playing Custard,
the cowardly dragon. There you go.
And it's based on an Ogden Nash poem, I think.
Yeah,
right?
I think there's a few books or something like an Ogden children's story thing. The music's by Brad Ross. It was. Premiered in 2002 at Lincoln Center, actually, and then they did it again in off-Broadway in 2008, and I believe we're the third production of it, and it's 55 minutes. It's a lot of fun.
It's a one-shot deal?
One-shot deal. Well, I mean, they've got a bunch of other kids that perform professionally, and it's just tough to fit the schedules in.
Yeah.
So.
You got everybody in. Are you doing this as a favor to Judith? Because you went to school, and she was your teacher.
Yeah,
we've
kind of volunteered our time to come and do this, and it's nice to be able to give back to the community and all that stuff, and it's a special group of people. It's a special cast, and it's been actually very chaotic with the rehearsal process.
I can only imagine.
Day at a time here, you know, everybody's gone, and we actually the first time we were together as a group was yesterday.
Wow!
Oh my goodness!
Yeah,
it's at the Thomas Bell Auditorium at Aquinas on Dewey Avenue. Tickets are $10. You can get them at EmpireStateLyricTheater.org or at the door.
At tomorrow, 2 p.m. Yep. 2 p.m. tomorrow afternoon.
2 p.m.
Right?
Tomorrow.
It's an afternoon production.
And after you leave here. You going back to New York? You got a gig lined up?
I'm going back to New York. I was actually going to get you guys some tickets for the Austin Powers musical if you want to come and sit next to me there.
So. The most annoying thing ever.
Yeah.
They're just trying anything, aren't they?
Hey, man, you know there's a Rocky musical they're making?
Oh, God, I do remember.
How's Rocky going to sing?
I'm a
what are you doing there? Come on.
They will try anything. Is Spider-Man actually playing now?
Spider-Man's playing.
Did it make it? I mean, it had so many problems.
Well, you know, what?
Yeah, okay.
You know, we'll reserve comment on that, but... it's still going.
Have you seen it? Is it any good?
I haven't seen it. I've had a lot of friends see it. They say, you know what? It's a lot better from the first like thing they saw before they shut it down and reworked it. Yeah, and it's technically really great, but I mean, spending $70+ million on a musical is just insanity, right? I mean, that's
total. Yeah.
It's just money to burn.
Yeah. I mean, the Yankees don't spend that on pitching anymore.
I know.
All right. Well, all right. Break lots of legs tomorrow.
Thank you.
Have fun with this.
Well, it was nice talking with you guys.
Nice talking to you, Kevin Green. It's so nice that, that you're doing so well, and we're expecting great things. So I know you won't disappoint. You get to spend holidays with your family, or you got to get out of here?
No, I'm actually going to be here through the new year. I got a lot of my good friends are coming up.
Great.
We're going to have a good time hanging out.
There's a lot of kids from Rochester, for between your school and some of the other schools and School of the Arts, that are on Broadway.
There's something in the water here, Tony. Yeah, I swear to you. I don't know what it is. It's really... really kind of awesome,
especially
to see
in Greece, don't you think? Sort of the West Side really produces.
My wife used to teach at School of the Arts, and every year we would go down with a whole group of people there, and we'd go and watch the shows that the kids were in, or some of them were backstage people, whatever. Mm. But we'd go to all those shows, and we'd meet up with some of them. And there's so many; it's ridiculous. Yeah. It's unbelievable.
Well, there's also a great passion for the arts in Rochester, which I think is really special, and I think that nurtures kind of that involvement in theater at a young age, and. Yeah, kids do it.
That's beautiful. We're glad you're successful. You're having a lot of fun.
I am.
All right. Kevin Green, thank you.
All right, take it easy, guys.